Salvation of our souls, let us pray. the captives and for their salvation. Let us pray for the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For our deliverance from all affliction, wrath, danger, and necessity, let us pray for the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
Help us, save us, have mercy on us, and protect us, O God, by your grace.
Lord, have mercy.
Our whole life to Christ our God.
lest the just themselves apply their hands to iniquities. Do good, O Lord, to those who are good, and to those whose heart is upright. But those who stray unto crooked ways, the Lord will expel with evildoers. Peace upon Israel.
When the Lord returned the captives to Zion, we were like men driven. Then our mouths were filled with laughter and our tongue with rejoicing. Then it was said among the Gentiles, the Lord has done great things for them. The Lord has done great things for us. We have been made to rejoice. O Lord, return our captives, that stream return to the south. Those who weep as they sow shall rejoice as they reap. Though they went forth shedding tears, as they scattered their seed, they shall return to rejoicing, bearing with them their sheep.
Unless the Lord builds a house, in vain do the builders toil. Unless the Lord guards the city, in vain does the watchman keep watch. In vain do you rise early. You get up after rest, only to eat the bread of grief, for he provides for his beloved while they sleep. Behold, the Lord's inheritance is his children, and his reward the fruit of the womb. As arrows in the hand of a mighty warrior, so are the children of the exiles. Blessed the man who will be able to fill his quiver with them. They shall never be put to shame when they meet their foes at the gates.
Blessed are all who fear the Lord, who walk in his ways. You shall eat of your hand's labor. Blessed are you, and it shall be with you. Your wife shall be like a fruitful vine in the recess of your house, your children like olive shoots around your table. Behold, in this way shall the blessed the man who fears the Lord. May the Lord bless you from Zion, and may you see wealth of Jerusalem all the days of your life, and may you see your children's children peace upon Israel.
They have assailed me since my youth. Let Israel say it. Often they have assailed me since my youth, but they have not prevailed over me. The wicked plowed my back. They increased their iniquity, but the righteous Lord has cut asunder the neck of the sinners. Let them all be confounded and turn back, those who hate Zion. Let them become like grass on the housetops, which withers before it can sprout, with which the reaper feels not his hand, nor the binder of sheaves his arms. While those who pass, they do not say, the blessing of the Lord be upon you. We have blessed you in the name of the Lord. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and forever and ever. Amen. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia. Glory to you, O God. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia. Doxa sia Deus. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia. Glory to you, O God. Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
Again and again, peace, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
Help us, save us, have mercy on us, and protect us, O God, by your grace.
Lord, have mercy.
Remember Abraham, holy, pure, most blessed, and glorious baby, the pale Pope was never virgin Mary with all the saints. Let us commend ourselves to one another in our whole life to Christ our God.
Remember David and all his forbearance. I will not enter the tent, my abode, nor get up on the couch of my repose. I will give no sleep to my eyes, nor to my eyelids any slumber, nor to my temples any rest, until I find a place for the Lord, a tabernacle for the God of Jacob. Behold, I have heard of it in Ephrathah. We found it in the forest clearings. Let us enter into his tabernacles, let us worship where his feet once stood. Arise, O Lord, and go to your rest, you in the ark of your holiness. May your priests be clothed in righteousness, and your faithful ones rejoice. For the sake of David, your servant, turn not away the face of your anointed one. The Lord swore to David a promise which he will not retract. One of your own flesh I will place on your throne. If your sons will keep my covenants and the revelations I will offer them, their sons also shall be seated upon your throne forevermore. For the Lord has elected Zion. He has chosen it for his dwelling. This is my home forever and ever. Here I will dwell because I have chosen it. I will bless abundantly her provisions. I will feed her poor with bread. I will clothe the priest with salvation, and the faithful shall exult with joy. There will I raise the cry of thee that I have ready to lamp for my anointed one. I will clothe his enemies with shame, but on him my crown shall shine.
Behold how good and pleasant it is for brothers to draw unity. It is an anointment upon the head, which runs down over the beard. The beard of Aaron runs down to the hem of his garment. It is like the dew of Hermon, which falls on the mountains of Zion, for there the Lord has ordained a blessing, life forevermore.
Behold now, bless the Lord, all you servants of the Lord who stand in the house of the Lord, in the courts of the house of our God. By night, lift up your hands to the holy places and bless the Lord. May the Lord who made heaven and earth bless you out of Zion. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and always and forever and ever. Amen. Alleluia, 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 glory to you, O God. Alleluia, 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 doxa sia feos. Alleluia, 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 glory to you, O God. Lord, our whole glory to you.
Again and again in peace, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
Help us, save us, have mercy on us. of the wicked shall never touch my head. Lest I hide when I pray that a finger cool my heart. attentive to the voice of my supplication. Jesus, across the Jordan you went, as when you stayed there, you said to your followers, our friend Lazarus has fallen, asleep, in fact, he has died, and he has been buried and laid in a tomb. My friends, I am glad for you, for through this you will surely learn that I have not ceased being God, knowing everything, although visibly I appear to be just a man. So let us go and bring him back to life, so that in this way death might experience fully in its own defeat, and might clearly feel the total destruction which I shall effect while granting mercy to the world.
If you, O Lord, should mark transgression, O Lord, who would stand? For there is forgiveness with you, faithful. Come and let us imitate Martha and Mary and dispatch as our messengers to Christ, glory be direction, so that he come now to us and resurrect our minds which grievously lie dead in earth as if in a tomb of neglect and of carelessness, wholly unfeeling, with no sense of the fear of God, and for not having in them the life-giving energy.
Here.
covenant redemption. He shall redeem Israel from all his transgression. Guided by the fear of God, you turned away your attention from the urges of the flesh and the bitter tyranny of the passions of beautifying your heart with the grace of virtue. You were pleasing in the eyes of God, and now your dwelling is where the hosts of holy monastics are, and you obtain deserved rest worthy of what you have been longing for. Therefore we entreat you, cease not commemorating us in prayer, O devout St. John, as we faithfully observe your holy memory.
Praise the Lord, all you Gentiles. Praise him, all you peoples. You set out to find your God in this your never wavered. You were lifted on the wings of your sacred studies.
Oh, Son of God, giver of life. Behold, the universal Savior of glory.
Spare us the evening.
The kingdom forth shall be Psalm 114. I will be praising to the Lord in the land of the living. I am glad the Lord will hear my plea.
Wisdom.
The reading is from Genesis.
Let us be attentive.
When Joseph came home, they brought into the house to give the present, which they had with them, and bowed down to him to the ground. And he inquired about their welfare and said, "Is your father well?" The old man of whom you spoke, is he still alive? They said, "Your servant, our father, is well. He's still alive." And they bowed their heads and made obedience. And he lifted up his eyes and saw his brother Benjamin, his mother's son, and said, "Is this your youngest brother of whom you spoke up to me? God be gracious to you, my son." Then Joseph made haste, for his heart yearned for his brother, and he sought a place to meet. And he entered his chamber and wept there. Then Joseph could not control himself before all those who stood by him, and he cried, "Make everyone go out for me." So no one stayed with him when Joseph made himself known to his brother. And he wept aloud, so that the Egyptians heard it, and the household of the Pharaoh heard it, and Joseph's brothers, "I am Joseph. Is my father still alive?" But his brothers could not answer him, for they were dismayed at his presence. So Joseph said to his brothers, "Come near to me, I pray you." And they came near him. And he said, "I am your brother, Joseph, whom you sold into Egypt. And now do not be distressed or angry with yourself because you sold me here. For God sent me here before you to preserve life. For the famine has been in the land these 2 years, and there are yet 5 years in which you will be neither plowing nor harvest. And God sent me before you to preserve for you a remnant on earth, and to keep alive for you many survivors. So it was not you who sent me here, but God. And he has made me a father to Pharaoh, and lord of all his house, and ruler over all the land of Egypt. Make haste and go up to my father and say to him, 'Thus says your son Joseph, God has made me lord of all Egypt. Come down to me, do not tarry. You shall dwell in the land of Goshen, and you shall be near me, and your children, and your children's children, and your flocks, your herds, and all that you have. And there I will provide for you, for there are yet 5 years of famine to come, lest you and your household and all that you have come to poverty. And now your eyes see, and the eyes of my brother Benjamin see, that it is my mouth that speaks to you. You must tell my father all my splendor in Egypt, and of all that you have seen. Make haste and bring my father down here." Then he fell upon his brother Benjamin's neck and wept. And Benjamin wept upon his neck, and he kissed all his brothers and wept upon them. And after that, his brothers talked with him. When the report was heard in Pharaoh's house, Joseph's brothers had come. It pleased Pharaoh, and his servants well.
Prohibitum, fourth tone, Psalm 115. I will fulfill my vows to the Lord in the presence of all his people. I believe, therefore, I have spoken, but I was dire with the effect. Give the command. Chosen rather than great riches, and favor is better than silver or gold. The rich and the poor meet together. The Lord is the maker of them all. A prudent man sees danger and hides himself, but the simple go on and suffer for it. The reward for humility and the fear of the Lord is riches and honors, honor and life.
Peace be to you all.
Thank you.
lust of power, and idle talk. But rather give to me, your servant, the spirit of prudence, humility, patience, and love. Yes, Lord and King, grant me to see my own faults and not to judge my brother. You are blessed unto the ages of ages. Amen. Yes, O Lord and King, grant me to see my own faults and not to judge my brother, for you are blessed unto the ages of ages. Let us say with our whole soul and with our whole mind, let us say,
Lord, have mercy.
Lord Almighty God of our fathers, we pray to you, hear us and have mercy. Have mercy on us, O God, according to your great mercy. We pray to you, hear us, and have mercy.
Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy.
We pray for all pious and Orthodox Christians.
Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy.
We pray for Archbishop and Father Sava.
Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy.
You are a merciful God who loves mankind. And to you we give glory. To the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and forever, and to the ages of ages.
Amen.
Catechumens, pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
See the faithfulness, pray for the catechumens.
Lord, have mercy.
That the Lord will show the mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
That he will instruct them in the word of his truth.
Lord, have mercy.
That he will reveal to them the gospel of righteousness.
Lord, have mercy.
That he will unite them to his holy Catholic and apostolic church.
Lord, have mercy.
Save them in mercy and help them to keep them, O God, of your grace.
Lord,
you are dead, you bow your heads to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
That with us they too may glorify your most noble, majestic name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit, now and forever, to the ages of ages.
Amen.
All catechumens depart, the catechumens depart. All who are admitted for illumination, come forward. Pray all of you who are admitted, prepared for illumination. Let us pray to the Lord. All you faithful for our brethren, being made ready for holy illumination for their salvation, let us pray to the Lord. Lord, our God will confirm them and strengthen them. Let us pray to the Lord. That he will enlighten them with the light of understanding and piety. Let us pray to the Lord. That he will make them worthy of the things on the left, the remission of their sins, the garment of corruption. Let us pray to the Lord. Render them born again by water and the Spirit. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord,
have mercy. So endowed with perfect faith, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
So you will number them among his holy and chosen flock. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
Save them in mercy and in help of the kingdom of God in your grace.
Lord, have mercy.
So you are admitted for illumination by your heads to the Lord.
Lord,
for you are illumination, to you we offer glory. To the Father, to the Son, to the Holy Spirit, now and forever, and unto the ages of ages.
Amen.
All who are for illumination depart, those who are for illumination depart, all catechumens depart, let the catechumens remain. All the faithful again and again in peace, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
Help us, save us, have mercy on us, and protect us, O God, by your grace.
Lord, have mercy.
Please come. For to you belong all glory, honor, and worship to the Father, to the Son, and the Holy Spirit, now and forever, to the ages of ages.
Amen.
Again in peace, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
Help us, save us, have mercy on us, and protect us, O God, by your grace.
Lord, have mercy.
Wisdom to the Master, infinitely good. We entreat your rich mercy, we entreat you, rich in mercy, to be gracious to us, and to make us worthy to receive you, your only begotten Son. By our God, which is glory. For behold, his spotless body and life-giving blood are about to make their entrance at this hour, to be laid on this mystical table, invisibly attended by a multitude of the heavenly hosts. Grant that we may receive them in blameless communion, so that as the eyes of our understanding see the light, we may become children of light and of the day. Through the gift of your Christ, with whom you are blessed, together with your all-holy good and thy great spirit, now and forever, for the ages of ages.
Thank you.
Let us complete our evening prayer to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For the precious and for sanctified gifts you have set forth, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
That our loving God hath received him at his holy and visible and celestial altar as an offering of spiritual fragrance, may in return send down upon us the divine grace and the gift of the Holy Spirit. Let us pray.
Lord, have mercy.
That we may be spared all affliction, violence, pain. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
Help us, save us, have mercy on us, and protect us, O God, by your grace. That the whole evening may be perfect, holy, peaceful, and sinless, let us ask of the Lord.
Of this, O Lord.
For an angel of peace, a faithful guide, guardian of our souls and bodies, let us ask of the Lord.
Of this, O Lord.
For forgiveness and remission of our sins and transgressions, let us ask of the Lord. Profitable for our souls and for peace for the world, let us ask of the Lord. For the completion of the remaining time of our lives in peace and repentance, let us ask of the Lord. For admission ending to our lives, peaceful without shame and suffering, and for a good defense at the dread judgment seat of Christ, let us ask.
Lord,
having prayed for the unity of the faith and for the communion of the Holy Spirit, let us commend ourselves and one another and our whole life to Christ our God.
Lord,
O God of ineffable and unseen mysteries, and you are hidden treasures of wisdom. Knowledge, and yet you have revealed to us this liturgy, and in your great love for mankind, appointed us sinners to offer gifts and sacrifices to you for our sins and for the families of the people. Invisible King, you perform works great and inscrutable, glorious and extraordinary beyond all. Look upon us, your undeserving servants, as we stand as at your throne of the cherubim, and at this your holy altar, where your only begotten Son, our God, rests in the awesome mysteries you offer, freeing us all of your faithful people of all unclean, sanctify all of us, soul and body, with the sanctification that cannot be taken away. Thus, partaking of these divine blessings with pure conscience, faces unblushing, hearts enlightened, and being quickened by them, you may be united to your Christ himself, worshiping God. For he said, he who eats my flesh and drinks my blood abides in me, and I am having your word, indwelling and moving within us. May we thus become the temple of your all-holy and worshipful Spirit, free of every wild of the evil, and effective our acts, our words, and our thoughts, and so retain the blessings promised to us, as to your saints who have pleased you throughout the evening. And make us worthy, Master, with confidence and without fear of reproach, to make bold to call you the heavenly God, Father, and to say,
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven.
Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For that is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, now and forever, and unto the ages of ages. Grace and mercy and love for us of your only begotten Son, with whom you are blessed giving her all holy, good life, great spirit, now and forever to ages of ages. Let us be attentive, the priest sanctified holy gifts, for the holy people of God, the prayers manna aia, peace Let us commend ourselves to one another and our whole life to Christ our God. God, our Savior, of all forms, blessed you have bestowed on us the communion of the Holy Body and blood of your Christ. We pray, you loving Lord, keep us in the shelter of your wings, and grant that to our very last breath we may partake worthily of your sanctifying blessings for the enlightenment of soul and body, for the inheritance of the heavenly. For you are our sanctification, and to you we give glory, the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and forever, and unto the ages of ages. Let us depart in peace. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
Almighty Lord, you have created all things in wisdom, in your inexpressible providence and great goodness. You have brought us to these saving days for the cleansing of our souls and bodies, for the control of our passions, and the hope of the resurrection. After the 40 days, you have delivered into the hands of your servant Moses the tablets of the law in characters divinely traced. Enable us also, O benevolent one, to fight the good fight, to complete the course of the fact, to keep the faith inviolate, to crush underfoot the heads of unseen tempters, to emerge victors over sin, to come without reproach to the worship of your holy resurrection. For blessed and glorified is your most honorable and majestic name, of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, now and forever, the ages of ages.
Painful. Those who hate justice shall be damned. The Lord will redeem the none of those who hope in him shall be lost.
I will exalt you, my God and my King, and bless your name forever and ever. Every day I will bless you and praise your name forever and ever. The Lord is great and greatly to be praised, and to his greatness there is no end. Age after age will praise your works and proclaim your might. They will tell the glorious splendor of your holiness. They will recount your wondrous works. They will speak of the power of your awesome deeds. They will declare your greatness. They will recall your abundant goodness and will exalt your righteousness. The Lord is gracious and merciful. He is long-suffering and abounding in love.
The Lord is good towards everyone, and his grace extends over all his works. Let all your works give thanks to you, Lord, and all your faithful ones bless you. They shall speak of the glory of your kingdom and tell of your power to make known your might to the children of men and the glorious splendor of your kingdom. Your kingdom is a kingdom for all ages, and your dominion is for all generations. The Lord keeps faith in all his promises and is hallowed in all his works. The Lord supports all who are failing and rises up all who are bowed down.
The eyes of all look up to you, and you give them their food in due season. You open your hands and satisfy all living beings. The Lord is just in all his ways and faithful in all his works. The Lord is close to all who pray to him, those who call upon him in truth. He will meet the desire of those who fear him and hear your pleas and save them. The Lord keeps watch over those who love him, but the wicked he will utterly destroy. My mouth will speak the praise of the Lord, and let all flesh bless his holy name forever and to all eternity.
Through the prayers of our holy fathers, Lord Jesus Christ, our God, have mercy on us and save us. Please join us for a minute while we have some food together.